Hi guys, this is Mina. Welcome back to my channel. As you already know, it is always a good idea to back up databases to prevent complete data loss. In my previous video, I showed you how to manually create a database backup. Today, I'm going to demonstrate creating backups automatically on a schedule. SQL Server Management Studio supports three types of backups. They are the full backup, which backs up all the data, table, and everything within your database. And next, we have differential backup, which backs up data that has changed since the last full backup. And lastly, there is the log backup that backs up the SQL Server transaction log. Let's move on to the SQL Server Management Studio and demonstrate the automatic database backup procedure. Inside SQL Server Management Studio, I'm going to open Management. And one of the options under Management is Maintenance Plan. If I open Maintenance Plan, you see that I have no maintenance plan set up yet. So I'll right-click on Maintenance Plan and select Maintenance Plan Wizard. I'll go to Next. In this dialog box, I can set up some tasks, including database backup. So let's give a name to our maintenance plan. I'm going to call it database backup. Description just helps us to remember what this backup is all about. You can add a description if you want, but I prefer to leave it empty for this tutorial. And we can either set up separate schedule for each task or have a single schedule for the entire plan. So I'm going to go with single schedule for the entire plan. And to the right, I would click on change. In this interface, I can set up the schedule. We can either select daily, weekly, or monthly database backup schedule. I prefer to go with weekly. So it reoccurs every week on the Sunday, and it should start from 12 a.m. midnight. So my backup can be completed successfully without any interference. I will accept all the default settings here and click on OK. Then I'll click on Next and select the task that I want. So I can select either full backup or differential backup or even transaction backup, if you want to do all the backups at the same time. I prefer to do both full and differential backup in this tutorial, so I'll select both options and go to Next. Here I have the option to set the sequence in which this backup should occur. So I prefer to have full backup done first, followed by differential backup. I can use move down, move up option to other my tasks. Let's go on to Next. In this dialog box, I have three options: general, destination, and options. Under general, I get to select the database that I want to back up. I'm going to back up my student records database. You can select multiple databases if you want. You can also select all databases if that's what you want to do. So I'm going to just back up my student record database. I'm going to click OK. And I want to back up the whole database, not some files or file group. Under destination, I need to specify where the files are going to be saved. As you can see, my default location has been selected, which is in the C drive. So I would go with that. If you wish to change this file location, you can click on this dialog box and change that location as well. I'm going to cancel because I prefer this location. Everything seems good on this page. So I'll move on to the options tab. Here I wish to compress my database size and also verify my backup integrity and go to Next. Here I need to set up the option for the differential backup task. So let's select the database. It's student record. Okay. and we are backing up the database and to this. These default settings are okay with me, so I'll go on to the next tab, which is destination. File location is also good. Under the option tab, again, I want to compress my database backup and verify the backup integrity. I will hit on next. Here it is asking me what I would like to do when the backup is finished. It defaults to write to a text file. You can optionally send an email report when you are done, but I wish to maintain the write to text file in this tutorial. I'll then click on the next button at the bottom here. And this gives me a summary of my backup tasks. I'll go ahead and click finish. So as you can see, I have a bunch of green check marks. And now I have the word success. This is what we are all looking for when setting up our maintenance plan for backups. So I'll hit on the close option. Now under maintenance plan, you can see that I have my database backup listed here. It means I finally have a backup plan for my database student record, which will automatically kick off and back up all my student record database every week at 12 a.m. on Sundays. If you want to test this backup, you can run the maintenance plan. So I would right click on it and execute. Always make sure that your SQL Server agent has been started before you execute your maintenance plan. Otherwise, it's not going to work. Okay, I'll close this dialog box and go to my backup file location. And these are the backups that we've just done. If you want to know which one is the full backup, look at the file size. Full backup is always larger than differential backup. So guys, this is how to set up automatic backups on schedule in SQL Server Management Studio. In my next video, I'll show you how to restore backups in SQL Server Management Studio. Thank you so much for watching this video and see you in my next one. Bye-bye.